Okay, so for this last exercise, we're going to just take our finished web app and create a new version. We're going to save this project with a new file name, call it Zen App Smartphone. And I'm going to now make a smartphone version of our web app. So I'm going to head over to our project symbols. And now I'm going to just change our app template symbol so that it will be a little smartphone viewport. I'm going to get a ratio calculator that I use. And I know that I want to have a 320 pixel wide screen, and it has to be a 16:9 ratio, so that matches the iPhone. And I'm going to add an iPhone control here, and I had previously figured out that 400 by 812 will fit my 320 pixel viewport within that phone control. And then I'm just going to move the buttons around, change the menu button to a hamburger menu icon, and I size down our Zen logo there. So if I jump back to this wireframe, I'm going to revert my changes to get the updates from the symbol. And now I'm doing some changes here that might work better for the smartphone. So I'm going to add a button bar to the top. And maybe, you know, this is one way to switch between a welcome message and, you know, viewing our specials for the restaurant. All right, so I decided maybe that the specials might look good as a little scrollable gallery of the items. So I'm going to add an image here for the first special. And the idea is here is that you have a set of pictures and the name of the menu item, and you can just swipe through the specials when you're on the welcome screen or the landing screen. So I'm just going to overlay a panel here so that I can put my text on top of the image. This way it's nice and compact, so it'll fit in this smartphone screen. All right, so that's looking decent. I jumped ahead here, changed colors a little bit, and I'm going to group this. And here I'm just going to just put in a bunch of these images. And, you know, I just did a couple changes there to make it look like it might fit a little better. All right, so now we're on our menu screen. And I copied the symbol from the landing screen, pasted it in here, and I'm going to send it to the back. And now I have my menu. And for this view, I'm thinking, you know, selecting the hamburger icon in the upper left will slide the menu into the view. So I changed my list to fit here, and I'm just going to change the list height so that it fits within the viewport. And then I'm going to take my submenu, resize it so that it would fit on the other side of the screen as well. All right, so now the idea is I have the menu sliding in, and it fits in right underneath the toolbar. And I'm going to unlock this, and I'm going to change the hamburger icon to show that it's selected. All right, cool. So we're going to go through all the screens and make these changes. This is the tacos section, so we're going to do the same thing. Delete all the unnecessary parts. Resize everything to fit within our app template in the background. Here on the tacos view, this should be slightly different as well. Let's see what we can do here. We're going to take out the little previous and next boxes or cards, and I'm going to just fit this main card into the viewport, resize everything, and lay things out a little cleaner. Here we go. And then we just have some pagination at the bottom. Here's the modify screen, and here's the popover for showing that we added this to cart. Here's our pay page laid out a little better, and here's our payment confirmation laid out. So now if we jump to full screen view, you could demonstrate this flow. So here we're clicking the menu, jumping through to tacos, jumping over to the menu item, modifying the order. And we're done. We're going back to the item and then ordering it. It shows the cart. We send that to kitchen. We enter our payment information and we see our confirmation screen. And that wraps up our rapid wireframing course. In the next section, I'm just going to go over some reminders to keep you working fast and using wireframes in a way that supports your goals for getting a better product and better product design out of your team. So we'll see you in a minute.